Hi everyone. Today in this video, we are going to discuss about fluvoxamine. What is this drug fluvoxamine? This drug belongs to the category of SSRIs, selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors. These drugs are inhibiting the reuptake of serotonin selectively. That's why they are called as selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors. Here, within the name of this drug, we can find some of the structural information. The prefix flu indicates this drug is having a trifluoromethyl group. And the second term V indicates it is having valrophenone structure. Now, this trifluoromethyl group is attached to valrophenone at the para position. And the term OX indicates this drug is an oxime derivative. The suffix amine indicates this drug is forming an oxime with two amino ethyl side chain. So this is the fluvoxamine, which is having the trifluoromethyl group, which is attached to the para portion of valrophenone, and this valrophenone forms an oxime with amino ethyl side chain. Then what is the use of this fluvoxamine? This drug is particularly used as an antidepressant in the treatment of Obsessive Compulsive Disorder, OCD. In the patients with OCD, we can observe repeated thoughts and actions which are associated with few of the obsessions. This obsessive behavior leads to some compulsions in the patients. For example, the patient may have fear of contamination, fear of insults, fear of harm to self or to others, and extreme concern with order, symmetry, as well as precision. So all these are the obsessions which can be observed within the patients, which lead to few of the compulsive behavior, such as repeated washing of hands, checking the things repeatedly, rearranging the objects repeatedly to make them in order or in symmetry, or repeated counting of objects. All these are observed in the patients with some anxiety, where fluvoxamine can be used to control this obsessive compulsive disorder. Now let us see the chemical nature of this drug. So this is the structure of fluvoxamine. Here we can observe a phenyl ring with 5 carbon chain, and this 5 carbon chain is forming an oxime at the first position. So the simple ring system along with this 5 carbon chain is the valrophenone. This valrophenone forms an oxime with 2 amino ethyl chain. So we can write this as O-2-aminoethyloxime. So that is the simple structure of fluvoxamine. Fluvoxamine is a valrophenone oxime derivative with 2 amino ethyl chain. Then we can identify the side chains present. Let us give the numbering. So this is the 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So at the 5th position, it is having the methoxy group. We can write this as 5-methoxy. And trifluoromethyl group is present at the para portion of the phenyl ring. So we can write this as 4-trifluoromethyl. So that is the complete name of fluvoxamine. Now let us see how this drug acts. One of the important neurotransmitters within the CNS is the serotonin, 5-HT. This 5-HT can be released and it can act on the postsynaptic receptors, which are expressed with 5-HT receptors such as 5-HT2. So when the action potential reaches to the presynaptic nerve terminal, calcium can enter into the nerve terminal, which produces the exocytosis and release of 5-HT. This 5-HT can act on the 5-HT2 receptors to produce postsynaptic excitation. But the released 5-HT can be reuptaken into the nerve terminal by one of the transporter. This is the SERT, serotonin reuptake transporter. So here this transporter is having the two sides. This is the primary side and this is the allosteric side. Through this transporter, 5-HT can be taken into the nerve terminal, which reduces the action of 5-HT. Now, fluvoxamine is one of the antidepressant which blocks the reuptake of serotonin. That's why it is called as SSRI, selective serotonin reuptake inhibitor. This fluvoxamine can block both primary site as well as secondary site. Now, when these two sites are blocked, 5-HT cannot be reuptaken into the nerve terminal. So, 5-HT levels are increased within the synaptic cleft. In this way, fluvoxamine increases the serotoninergic transmission, which improves the depressive symptoms. So in the patients with obsessive compulsive disorder, the symptoms can be relieved by treatment with fluvoxamine. Apart from this action, fluvoxamine can also block other types of receptors such as alpha 1 receptors, 5-HT1 receptors, muscarinic receptors. Even it can act on the GABA. But the main action of fluvoxamine is attributed to its action on reuptake of serotonin. Now let us see the precautions of fluvoxamine. One of the important precautions of fluvoxamine is that just with other antidepressants, this drug can produce serotonin syndrome. So this syndrome is associated with excessive levels of 5-HT within the CNS, which results in few of the symptoms such as increased agitation, hallucinations, confusion, anxiety, increased heart rate such as tachycardia, increased body temperature, hyperthermia, increased sweating, diaphoresis, increased vasodilatory response, flushing, some tremor and muscle rigidity can be observed in the patients. So if any other drug which produces serotonin syndrome should be carefully combined with this fluvoxamine. For example, MAO inhibitors can increase the serotonin syndrome when they are combined with this fluvoxamine. Similarly, this drug can produce hyponatremia. The serum sodium levels are reduced less than 110 millimoles per liter. So when the serum sodium levels are reduced, it can produce few of the symptoms such as headache, confusion, impaired memory and muscle weakness. And all these symptoms are produced by fluvoxamine because this drug is going to inhibit the action of antidiuretic hormone. So fluvoxamine inhibits the action of vasopressin, which is an antidiuretic hormone. And particularly this hyponatremia is more significant in the patients who are volume depleted, or the patients who are using the diuretics like loop diuretics, or in the elder patients, this hyponatremia is more significant. So care should be taken when this fluvoxamine is prescribed in the elder patients or patients using diuretic agents. Similarly, this drug can also increase the suicidal initiation just like the other antidepressants. SSRIs can increase the suicidal thoughts. So this is because of anxiety, agitation, irritability and insomnia that is developed in the patients. So these symptoms can further increase the suicidal risk, and the risk is more associated in the children as well as adolescents with age less than 18 years and the young adults with age 18 to 24 years. In these patients, the suicidal risk is more pronounced. Similarly, fluvoxamine, when it is prescribed in the patients with unstable epilepsy or patients who are having the history of convulsions, in such patients, this drug can increase the risk of seizures. So care should be taken in these patients when this fluvoxamine is prescribed. Similarly, as an antidepressant, this drug can produce two phases, either manic phase or hypomanic phase. Since it is reducing the depression, it may elevate the CNS stimulation resulting in the manic phase in the patients. Otherwise, it can also produce hypomania. So any change in the mood in the patient should be carefully monitored when this fluvoxamine is prescribed. Similarly, this drug can increase the risk of bleeding. This may result in few of the conditions such as epistaxis, nasal bleeding, hematoma, and gastrointestinal bleeding in the patients. And this risk is further increased with other drugs such as aspirin, which is an antiplatelet agent, and warfarin, which is an oral anticoagulant, NSAIDs. All these drugs can increase the risk of bleeding produced by fluvoxamine. What are the side effects? The general side effects of fluvoxamine mainly include nausea, dizziness, insomnia, asthenia, lack of energy, agitation, some nervousness, fatigue, dry mouth, impotence, and upper respiratory tract infections such as rhinitis, tremor, and loss of libido in the patients. How it is given? This drug is available as a tablet form, and it is available at the three strengths such as 25 mg, 50 mg, and 100 mg. The initial dose of the drug is started at low dose such as 50 mg given at bedtime. The dose may be slowly increased at an increments of 50 mg and the recommended dose is variable from 100 to 300 mg per day. So whenever the dose is above 100 mg, it should be given as divided doses. But in the children with age less than 17 years, the initial dose is 25 mg given at bedtime. And again, the dose may be slowly increased at an increments of 25 mg such that the recommended dose is 100 to 200 mg per day. So that's about this fluvoxamine. Fluvoxamine is a selective serotonin reuptake inhibitor, SSRI. This drug selectively blocks reuptake of 5-HT by binding to the SERT, serotonin reuptake transporter, both at primary site as well as allosteric site, thereby it reduces the reuptake of 5-HT into the presynaptic nerve terminals. This results in the increased 5-HT levels within the synaptic cleft, thereby it increases serotoninergic transmission. This drug is useful in the treatment of obsessive compulsive disorder, and it is started at a low dose of 50 mg at bedtime. The dose may be slowly increased to achieve a dose of 100 to 300 mg per day. But in the pediatric patients, it is started at 25 mg and the dose is maintained from 100 to 200 mg per day. So that's about this drug, fluvoxamine. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.